so amazing that it contours to your face like that.
Wow.
I like the lush lips.
Oh yeah, look at that.
Amazing.
As a result of various connections, long-standing connections we've had with UCL, we were invited to potentially get involved with a project with the ENO, and it was around makeup and taking an application that we developed a few years ago called Face, which allowed you to try on cosmetics. And it seemed to be a really interesting sort of dovetailed aim here, where ENO were interested in allowing makeup artists to trial makeup. We were looking for more creative ways to use the technology.
The world of costume and makeup is a world that you don't often think about as one of the key areas of what we do, but of course it's inherent in every single production, and we have a fantastic makeup team here at ENO. So I was very excited by the potential to give some profile to that aspect of the company and the fact that it goes on and that singers have to sit in a makeup room before they walk on stage, and all these aspects to the world of opera and specific to ENO that we could make more visible.
From my perspective, I wanted it to be a project that wasn't too, it could be scoped enough for a third year undergraduate to feel comfortable that she wasn't going to drown and there wasn't great expectations. But also for me, it was an opportunity to see how we could develop a collaboration.
What Anna and her team did is develop four very different user journeys.
When it doesn't detect a face, it will just show this animation. And then when it detects a face, it will then show the makeup and play some music as well, depending on which character. Then the second journey will give you the option to choose between Akhenaten or Nefertiti. So if I wanted to try Akhenaten, I'd just click that side of the screen. And then it'll also give me the choice to change again here. So now I'm trying Nefertiti. The third journey here, if I take my face away, have a circle there for you to align your face to. So you just go in front, put your face in the circle, and it will come up with these buttons where, as you saw before, I could change between the looks. Then the last one here is a kind of mixture of all of them. So this one starts with the animation, and if I put my face in front of the camera, it will give me a choice of the two looks. So if I want to try Nefertiti, I could try her. And as you see, it's playing music. When I change to Akhenaten, the music will change as well as the look. And then I can take a photograph. And also, it'll give me a little bit of information about the opera. And yeah, those are the four journeys.
It's really good. It's really amazing.
Wow. Really nice. So, to match a specific, the makeup of every single style of face, you know, the shape, is really clever.
Wow, that's so amazing. Even the eyes and the mouth move perfectly. It's incredible technology. We're not seeing our performance, we're only experiencing it. So it's the way that it feels on stage, you know what I mean? And the way it makes us feel. So this gives us a sense of what it's gonna look like, which we don't actually know so much what it looks like, because we only see it in the mirror, but on stage with the lights, we don't know. So in that sense, this is a great tool for us to use.
I can see, yeah, the lighting's funny. But I couldn't work out whether that was my blush or on there.
It's quite subtle, so probably you can't really see it that well.
Yeah. It doesn't really matter.
So cool.
I think it's amazing. Thank you.
I really agree that having all these different user groups was one of the core strengths of this project. Because first we saw how children were interacting with it, and for them it was a completely different user experience.
You feel like you actually are the person, so it's like it changes it so quickly too.
So for us, thinking about which kind of features can add to this kind of virtual try-on is really, really precious.
Mm-hmm. No, I totally agree with it, because then we can pick on this knowledge that we got from this experience and then completely reuse it into our retail project. So I think it's a great opportunity to get a lot of data and see how people really interact with this kind of technology.
One of the things that I think that Steve Jobs did so well was reduce the distance between people and technology, and on your smartphone, you know, you integrate and engage with the apps on your homepage by using, but also by making mistakes. And I think people don't want to make mistakes or be seen to be making mistakes in a very public environment. So I think people do typically shy away from technology. It's much easier to get somebody else to have a go and, like an ass, I'm going to hide in the shadows. And that seems to have come out quite strongly. The technology that was hidden behind mirrors so that it looked like a makeup mirror was generally much better received and much better engaged with than just an iPad on a side.
We discovered all sorts of things that we hadn't envisioned it being used for. So particularly for the makeup artists, they were able to come up with many different ideas that we hadn't thought of before. For the principal singers, they thought it might distract them if music was playing, because they'd start listening to the music rather than looking at the makeup. But also for the kids, they started to think about, they hadn't realized that the performers, they don't just come onto stage and sing, they have to get made up, and they hadn't realized that they wear makeup. So those kind of things were quite interesting. And it got them thinking about what goes on behind the scenes, because they weren't really engaged with opera. They hadn't been before. They didn't, you know, they thought opera was boring. And this kind of got them thinking, it wasn't going to change their attitude, but it got them thinking about, well, what goes on behind the scenes? And then maybe in a few years' time, when they're starting to think about a career, they might think back, oh, I might like to work behind the scenes, or be even a makeup artist for opera. So I think it might have just sown that seed.
So working with the ENO has been fantastic. One, because they're a great brand. The people have been fantastic to work with. The product, the opera, the Philip Glass opera, Akhenaten, was a fantastic experience to be involved with. And it's a serious place where serious work is done. And to be able to weave ourselves into that was very, very positive. But also having an opportunity to talk to the people that are directly, who are actually doing the jobs, the people who are building the sets, the people who are designing the makeup, the people that are applying the makeup, fitted really, really well, because you know, digital cannot replace the reality of what they do. It's augmenting it, and I think they kind of got that really, really well. And then the opportunity of working with UCL and having access to Delia and to the team there was very, very useful for us. I think it was useful for them too to have a chance to put some theory into fact. But those, you know, Delia was fantastic, is fantastic. There is so much energy and enthusiasm, and the opportunity to do some of the programming as well and take some of the load off our shoulders as well was really, really positive. We've had a good time of it.
I think the project went really well in for all of the partners. So for Delia, she had the most amazing experience in terms of collaborating and working under pressure and deadlines and understanding what's involved in doing professional research in terms of developing an interface, but also working within the English National Opera and understanding what the demands are there and the pressures that they're put under. I think for Holition, it was a great opportunity for them to work both with the English National Opera as an arts company, but also with ourselves as an academic, and to see what the potential might be for doing more long-term collaborative projects. I'm really excited that we've already, you know, started to talk about how we might go about that. In particular, thinking about technology advance, the development of the technology for facial recognition, so it's not just 2D modelling, but it could be 3D modelling. And that will enable us to think about not just makeup, but also what other accessories you might place onto a face in real time. It could be ears, it could be horns, it could be hair, whiskers even. And that gives you an opportunity to think of a whole range of educational applications. And I think that would be great for the English National Opera to also think about the potential of using this in a wider range of contexts. So I think it's a win-win for all of us, and we certainly will be going back to the drawing board to look at how we might collaborate in the future.